Very good morning to all of you. Today our topic is radiotherapy in gynecology or radiation therapy in gynecological malignancy. So radiation therapy plays an important role in the management of gynecological malignancies. Nowadays there are many advances in the radiation therapy, so it has an important role in the management of gynecological cancers. So it has many roles. It has most important is curative role. So it has specific curative role, especially in the management of cervical cancer, which is the most commonly cancer seen in clinical practice. So it is completely cured in cancer cervix is completely cured by the radiation therapy. And radiation treatment may also be curative for localized endometrial cancer. And when surgery is not possible, though the surgery is the treatment of choice in case of endometrial cancer, but in some cases where surgery is impossible, then radiation therapy has a curative role in localized endometrial cancer. And it also improves prognosis if used as adjuvant postoperative therapy in advanced cervical and endometrial cancer. Means after surgery, it can be used as adjuvant therapy in cervical, advanced cervical and endometrial cancer. So the scope of radiation therapy has been enhanced in the management of cancers of vulva and vagina also. So in almost all gynecological cancers, it has a good scope in the treatment of all cases of cancers in gynecology. And in selected cases of cancer of the ovary, postoperative adjuvant radiotherapy may be beneficial. In some cases also, it is given as postoperative adjuvant radiotherapy in case of cancer ovary. We have also discussed to some extent while discussing the cancer ovary. Then in many cases, a judicious combination of radiotherapy and chemotherapy is also used. Combination of radiotherapy and chemotherapy were used and having good prognosis and survival period. Then cell death in terms of radiation biology is defined as the loss of clonogenic capacity or cell reproductive potential. This is the most important mechanism of action in case of radiation therapy, that is loss of reproductive potential of the cell or malignant cell. And next is ionizing radiation produces free radicals. In radiation therapy, the most important is ionizing radiation, which produces free radicals, which disrupt the reproductive integrity of the DNA. As you know, the DNA is the main target of the radiation therapy. So there is disruption of the reproductive integrity of the DNA producing cells, and thus control cell division and neoplasty growth. So the main target is DNA. And radiation affects both normal cells and tumor cells. This is also important because the normal cells are also damaged while the tumor cells are damaged. So now the aim is to minimize the damage of the normal cells and maximizing the damage of the tumor cells. The aim is now focused. So different advanced techniques are coming up, and for this, minimizing the damage of the normal cells with maximizing the damage of the tumor cells. Then dividing mitotic cells are most vulnerable by the radiation therapy. The dividing mitotic cells. So the mitotic or M phase of the cell cycle, the cells in the M phase of the cell cycle are mostly affected by the radiotherapy. Then grading of the dose, these are the some principles of the radiotherapy, and grading of dose of irradiation is done. So by grading the dose of irradiation, a differential effect can be attained by forcing the cancer cells to differentiate and thus lose their malignant potential. So there is loss of malignant potential of the malignant cells, and it also stimulates angioblasts and fibroblasts to grow into the tumor cell mass, thus dividing them into smaller nests of neoplastic cells. So as the angioblasts and fibroblasts grow into the tumor cell mass, then the whole tumor mass is divided into smaller nests of neoplastic cells, and at last the connective tissue, fibroblasts constrict. So there is cutoff of the tumor cell blood supply, causing tumor necrosis. So at last there is constriction of the connective tissue, fibroblasts, leading to reduction of the or cutting off of the tumor cell blood supply, causing tumor necrosis. Then anaplastic tumors thus respond better compared to well differentiated squamous cell tumors, as there are more dividing cells or proliferating cells in anaplastic tumor, so they are mostly affected. Then adenocarcinoma and sarcoma are poor responders. Then what are the basic principles of physics of radiation therapy? So basic physics principles are, number one is, radiation physics deals with the measurement of energy that is transferred from the radiation source to the tissue to be irradiated. So the therapeutic activity of radiation is mainly related to the process of ionization. The therapeutic activity of radiation is mainly related to the process of ionization. So there are two forms of photons, quanta of radiation, whose energy is proportional to their frequency and inversely proportional to their wavelength. So the ionizing radiations may be two types. First is electromagnetic radiation that includes X-rays and gamma rays, which are combined known as photons. And second is particulate radiation, including electrons, protons, and neutrons. Out of these two, electromagnetic radiation is commonly used. Gone out of sight. I'm gone. So there are two types of ionizing radiation, that is electromagnetic radiation, which is commonly used. So one form of ionizing radiation is electromagnetic radiation, including X-rays and gamma rays. So out of, in case of electromagnetic radiation, X-ray is G1, and these sources of energy have no mass and no electrical charge. So this type of energy is produced by the decay of the outside the atomic nucleus of the radiation, radiation source. They are produced in discrete quanta or photons. And the second one of electromagnetic ionization is gamma rays. So it is the result of decay of radioactive isotopes. It is the result of gamma rays are the result of decay of the atomic nucleus of the radioactive isotopes. So electromagnetic radiation with the shorter wavelengths has a higher frequency and hence higher energy. And the energy produced is measured in electron volts, EV, or MeV, million electron volts. The X-ray radiotherapy units can range from 50,000 EV to over 30 million EV electron volts. Then photon radiation is measured in curies, and one curie is defined as 3.73 10 to the power, this is not required. So irrespective of the source of electromagnetic photon radiation, the transmitted energy diverges from the source of energy and diminishes inversely at the square of the distance traversed. So this is the inverse square law. As the energy transmitted to the laterally or from the source, away from the source, it decreases to, so inversely proportional to the dose, that is 1 by d square. So it diminishes inversely at the square of the distance traversed. So the points away from the source gets less and less source, less energy, so less affected. And as the normal cells are away from the this source, tumor source, so it is less affected, less damaged according to the inverse square law. And X-rays and photons can be generated as a result of rapidly accelerated electrons in vacuum striking a target. And modern generators that accelerate these electrons to a high speed may do so in a circular fashion. There are two types of two methods, that is circular fashion, that is Betatron, or linear accelerator. Commonly, the linear accelerator is used nowadays. Then another type of radiation is particulate radiation, which is less commonly used than the electromagnetic radiation. It is also used, but it is produced by the subatomic particles having a discrete mass. So these particles are derived as a result of disintegration of radionuclides. So four different types, namely alpha particles, neutrons, protons, and electrons are produced in case of particulate radiation. Neutrons are highly penetrative and have no charge but have a large mass. So it has highly penetrative power, so it helps in damaging the tumor cells in depth, more depth. They cause high energy collisions with atomic nuclei, principally hydrogen in the tissues. The resultant recoil proton loses energy to the surrounding tissue by ionization causing cell death. So at last there occurs death of the tumor cells. Then protons are positively charged particles and can be produced directly by generators. The high energy beams produced are used for special applications like treatment of pituitary tumors, and to some extent also to the gynecological malignancies. Then alpha particles, that is helium nucleus, have very little penetrating power and are not of much practical use. Then electrons, also referred to as beta rays, which are also used in therapeutic cases and can be produced at different energies by machines for various therapeutic uses in gynecological malignancies. Then radiation biology. So photons, both gamma rays and X-rays, are called photons, and they act by dislodging the orbital electrons of the tissue through which they pass. So usually there are this collision produces a fast electron from the orbital electron. They produces the fast electron, the effect between the interaction between the photons and the tissue. There occurs fast electron is produced by the Compton effect, which then ionizes molecules along its path, producing secondary electrons and free hydroxyl radicals. So this is the commonest Compton effect, is the commonest interaction between the photons and the matter or tissue, according which there is dislodgement of fast electron from the orbital electrons, then it interacts or ionizes the molecules along its path, producing secondary electrons and free hydroxyl radicals, and also hydrogen. Then this process continues until the photon loses all its energy. Since 80% of the cell contains water, cellular radiation damage is mediated by the ionization of water and production of free radicals, hydrogen and hydroxide. So there is the most important is hydrogen and hydroxides are produced, which damage the tumor cells. So the free hydroxyl radical causes DNA cell damage. They cause damage to the DNA. Then the effect may be lethal or sublethal. When the effect is lethal and kill the cell, or it may be sublethal, in which case the cellular DNA may undergo repair and cell recovers by the other surviving cells. Then it may, if the effect is sublethal, not lethal, then it may undergo repair and there is recovery of the cell, recover from the injury or damage of the radiation therapy. Then the free molecular hydroxyl radicals react with molecular oxygen to form peroxides, H2O2. So when hydroxyl ion reacts with the molecular oxygen, then there is production of peroxides, H2O2, which again in turn damage the tissues. So hydrogen ion, hydroxyl ion and H2O2 or peroxides damage the tissues, tumor tissues. Therefore, oxygen is important to enhance photon effect, because with the addition of oxygen from the hydroxyl ion, there is production of H2O2, which may again damage the cells. Large tumors with poor blood supply have poor photon effect, and in hypoxic areas and are radio resistant. So when there is less oxygen or hypoxic cells, then they are less sensitive to the radiotherapy. Radiation in presence of anemia, again if there is presence of anemia, infection, and scar tissue, produces poor results. So hypoxic cells, then presence of anemia, infection, and scar tissue or fibrous tissue produces poor results. They are less responsive to the radiation therapy. Then what is LET? Linear energy transfer. The rate of loss of energy of an ionizing particle as it traverses a unit length of medium is known as linear energy transfer, LET. In case of photons, energy transfer from an X-ray or electromagnetic source, the LET is low. Linear energy transfer is low. So, multiple tissue bombardments are necessary to achieve a lethal dose. So, as the LET or linear energy transfer is low, many bombardments are required for achieving a lethal dose. Then what is oxygen enhancement ratio or OER? It is the ratio of radiation dose required for a given level of cell killing under hypoxic condition with dose needed near. So what is the ratio between the radiation dose required for the killing of tumor cells in hypoxic condition to the killing of the cells in the needed in air, which is dose needed in the air, that is oxygenated cells. Usually the hypoxic cells needs 2 to 3 times more radiation dose than the oxygenated cells, as hypoxic cells are less radio sensitive. As we have already discussed, oxygen is required for the formation of hydrogen peroxide from the hydroxyl group. So, and hydroxyl peroxide is lethal to the cells. Then radiation dose rate. Larger radiation doses per fraction cause largest number of tumor cell kills, as well as there occurs maximum damage to the normal tissues. Though with larger radiation doses, there occurs the largest number of tumor cell kill, but there occurs also largest damage to the normal tissues. And which is the which causes the side effects or complications, early and late complications due to damage of the normal tissues. So larger radiation dose causes also more toxic effects or side effects due to damage of the normal tissues. Then what is radiation resistance? So radiation resistance is associated with, these are the factors. First is due to rapid cell repair of radiation damage. So radiation resistance develops due to rapid cell repair of radiation damage. Usually there is cell repair is slow in case of tumor cell after radiation damage, but sometimes there occurs rapid cell repair of the tumor cells after radiation damage, which results in radiation resistance. Then another cause is active concentration of chemical radioprotectors. So like amoxicillin, so it protects the radiation effect. So radiation resistance is developed. Another factor of development of radiation resistance is cellular hypoxia. So again, hypoxic cells are less sensitive, we have already discussed. So there occurs resistance, radiation resistance. Then in case of particulate radiation, with large particles, neutrons, the ionization achieved is high, leading to high LET. More intense ionization and production of more toxic hydroxyl radicals. More toxic hydroxyl radicals are produced due to ionization. So there is more toxic hydroxyl radicals are produced. So there is greater lethal tissue effect independent of the tissue oxygenation. So successful radiotherapy requires a good balance between the doses to the tumor and to that of the surrounding structure, radiation tolerance, so that least damage is inflicted to the normal tissues. So the main aim is to less or minimum affection or damage to the normal tissues with maximal damage to the tumor cells. That is the main aim. And another aim is to deliver a high dose to the tumor and minimal dose to the normal tissues, and better the normal tissues should be spared so that there will be less complications and or side effects. Then radio sensitizers, 6-platin and 5-fluorouracil, enhance the lethal effects of radiation when given concomitantly along with the radiation therapy. When 6-platin or 5-fluorouracil are given along with the radiation therapy, then it will enhance the lethal effects of radiation. This is known as chemoradiation. So both chemotherapeutic agents and radiation are given simultaneously during the treatment. So this is known as chemoradiation. Usually commonly 6-platin is used along with the radiation therapy. An important principle to remember is that a given dose of radiation kills a constant fraction. You remember, this is the most important one. Understand, this is the given dose of radiation kills a constant fraction of tumor cells. A given dose of radiation kills a constant fraction of tumor cells, not constant number. Constant fraction of tumor cells. Hence, each repetitive setting achieves a constant, similar, a constant fraction reduction of tumor cell activity. So, for example, suppose the cell number initial tumor cells are 10 to the power 5 or 1 lakh, 10 to the power 5. Then after one dose of radiation, there is one constant fraction tumor is killed. So 10 to the power 5 means 10 to the power 5 minus 1. So 10 to the power 4. So after cell kill, the cell number is 10 to the power 4 means 10,000. So constant number. So then if another dose is given, again then constant fraction of tumor cells are killed. So initially second dose when given from 10 to the power 4, then it will become 10 to the power 3, 1,000. So constant fraction of cells are killed, not constant number. In first course, more number is killed. In second course, the different number is killed. So constant fraction of tumor cells are killed, not the constant number of tumor cells. You should remember. I think you could understand. So a given dose of radiation kills a constant fraction of tumor cells. As you know, there are four phases of cell cycle, G1 and synthesis and G2 and resting phase and mitosis. So rapidly dividing cells are the most radiosensitive. Higher response occur in case of anaplastic tumors. compared to a well differentiated ones, because in anaplastic tumors there are more rapidly dividing cells, rapidly proliferating cells are there. As radiotherapy affects the rapidly dividing cells more, then fractionation, fraction of radiation, usually radiotherapy is given in divided doses or in fractionations. So fractionation of radiation treatment permits effective treatment of tumor and minimizes complications which would result from the exposure of the normal tissues, bone marrow, normal intestine to a single large dose. So what is the benefit of fractionation of radiation instead of the whole dose of radiation at a time? Because the in fractionation of radiation kills the constant fraction of tumor cells as well as the normal cells. But in case of normal cells, the tissue recovery is rapid in compared to the recovery of the tumor cells. So if there is gap in between the second dose due to fractionation, then there is fully recovered normal tissues are fully recovered in compared to the less recovered tumor cells, as the recovery in tumor cells is less in compared to the normal tissues, or recovery is slow. And in case of tumor cells, and recovery in normal tissues are very rapid. So there may be complete recovery of the normal tissues in between the in interval of the two courses, different courses. That is why fractionation is most beneficial, so that there is less side effects due to complete recovery of the normal tissues. The more effective repair of normal tissue occurring between treatment fractions allows recovery of normal cells, as the recovery is rapid in case of normal cells. And most of familiar with the unit of measurement of amount of energy absorbed by the tissue called the RAD, radiation absorption rod, RAD, radiation absorption dose, RAD. So RAD is defined as 100 arcs of energy absorbed per gram of tissue. Then the term gray, that is 1 joule per kg, has been introduced, and nowadays the centigray is used. As you know, 1 gray is equivalent to 100 rads. So 1 gray means 100 centigray. So 100 centigray is equivalent to 100 rads. So 1 centigray is equivalent to 1 rad. So nowadays it is measured in the centigray or gray. Then what is the radiation biology? Following the interaction between the photons and the tissue, so radiation, photons or gamma rays, is transferred from the radiation source to the tissues undergoing irradiation. Then the free radicals liberated produce tissue damage. Mitotic cells are killed more commonly. Mostly, the mitotic cells are affected and killed due to lethal effect of the radiation dose, and undergo differentiation if there is non-lethal dose. But in subsequent doses, even if the previous doses are sublethal due to accumulation of the sublethal doses, then there may occur lethal effect to the tumor cells in subsequent doses. So effects of photons with matter are photoelectric. Actually, there are 3 effects of interaction of photons with the matter or tissue, that are photoelectric effect, Compton scattering, and paired production. But out of all these three, Compton scattering is the major interaction of photons with the matter in case of human cancer. That we have discussed about the Compton scattering from by which there occurs the scattering of the electrons, fast electrons, and from which then ionization of the molecules, production of the hydrogen, hydroxyl, and H2O2, which are lethal to the tumor cells. Then proliferation of angioblasts and fibroblasts, and we have discussed, and then the effect of transmitted energy, irrespective of the source of irradiation, as it diverges from the source of origin, rapidly diminishes inversely at the square of the distance traveled. It is also important mechanism in according to the inverse square law. And then there are two types of radiation sources, that is external radiation, external beam radiotherapy or radiation therapy or teletherapy or internal or brachytherapy. As the name suggests, in teletherapy, the radiation source is outside the body of the patient. That is known as external beam radiation therapy. And in case of internal radiotherapy, that is known as brachytherapy, here the radiation source or sources are given inside the body of the patient. So internal radiation source. So this is the cross-section of an operative specimen demonstrating the correct positioning of the radium in the Manchester insertion. We'll discuss about detail about different methods are there, Manchester, Paris, and Stockholm method. So first of all, we'll discuss about the brachytherapy or internal radiotherapy, where it is a form of brachytherapy, is a form of radiation therapy in which the source is placed close to the tumor or also inside the tumor also. So here in the brachytherapy, the radiation source is used or placed close to the tumor or inside the tumor. So it may be, the application may be in the form of needles implanted into the tumor, that is interstitial, or placed in the vagina, cervical canal, or uterine cavity, intracavitary, in tandem with vaginal ovoids or use of orthostats. So brachytherapy may be intracavitary, interstitial, or surface or intraperitoneal. So intracavitary may be intrauterine, intracervical, and intravaginal, according to the placement of the radiation source. So in interstitial, it is inside the tumor, and in intracavitary, it is close to the tumor. Radiation source is placed close to tumor, and surface at the skin, that is also used sometimes. And in intraperitoneal, another is intraperitoneal radiotherapy, that is radiation source is placed in the peritoneal cavity. So these are the brachytherapy, intracavitary mainly, or interstitial. So in case of cervical and uterine cancer, brachytherapy comprises a central uterine and two ovaries in the vaginal wall. So one central uterine tandem is placed inside the uterine cavity, and two ovaries or orthostats in the vaginal penises are given usually. and this positioning irradiates the primary growth as well as the parametrium and obturatory lymph nodes. Parametrium also, this is the brachytherapy. So before radiation given, on the different, all the investigations should be done, should be fit for the radiation therapy. Was mostly checking the hemoglobin. She should not have anemia, because which is again anemia causes the less response to the radiotherapy, and total leukocyte count, rectal enema or suppository to be given, and antibiotics should be also given. So under antibiotic cover, the radiation therapy is given. So what are the methods of radiation therapy? Under general anesthesia, a self-retaining Foley's catheter is inserted into the bladder. Then the cervix is dilated to allow the insertion of the uterine tube. Uterine tandem is to be placed inside the uterine cavity. So cervix has to be dilated. Then after inserting the long empty device, like tandem, two rubber ovoids or platinum boxes are placed in the vagina furnaces. Then the vagina is then packed with sterile gauze to protect the bladder and rectum. Anterior, posterior and lateral x-rays of the pelvis are taken to check the or to confirm the correct position of the devices given inside the uterine cavity and also inside the vagina. That should be confirmed. The correct position is to be confirmed by the x-rays. Then the radioactive substance is then loaded after into the device by remote control of after loading technique. So first already given the empty boxes. After that, radioactive substances are loaded by remote control after loading technique, mainly to prevent the affection of the paramedical staffs, and especially the nursing staffs are who are involved the medical staff. So remote control after loading technique, the radioactive substances are loaded. So there are different techniques like Paris method, Stockholm method and Manchester technique. So this is the amount and type of reading, radium, number of applications and duration. So in case of Paris method, intrauterine tube of 33.3 milligram to vaginal ovaries, that is 33.3 milligram. And here only one application, and 5 days for duration is for 5 days, and each day radium is removed, cleaned and replaced. Then in Stockholm method, the intrauterine tube of 50 milligram and two vaginal ovaries of 50 to 60 milligram. There are three applications in Stockholm method, and each application of 48 hours each with a gap of 1 week between first and second. There is a gap of 1 week between the first and second, and 2 weeks between second and third. Then Manchester technique. Here, the intrauterine tube of 50 milligram and vaginal orpostat 30 to 50 milligram. And in this technique, there are two applications. And one application lasting for 72 hours at interval of 1 week. There is usually commonly Manchester technique is used. So in this figure, it shows the positioning of the radium in a Manchester technique in the uterine cavity. Then three methods we have already discussed. In the Paris method, the radium, which is removed daily for cleaning, is applied continuously for 5 days. And in the Stockholm method, the radium is inserted on 3 occasions with intervals of 7 days between the first 2 insertions and 2 weeks after the last insertion. Each insertion lasted for 48 hours. And in Manchester technique, 2 insertions of 72 hours each at a week, 1 week interval. So this is the Manchester technique. This is the Paris technique. And this is the Stockholm technique. In brachytherapy, various radioisotopes are used depending on their half-life in general. And those with a short half-life may be placed in the patient and left permanently, like radioactive gold, whose half-life is 2.7 days. Whereas those with a longer half-life are left temporarily in the patient and removed after the prescribed dose of radiation, like cesium-137. During brachytherapy, it is important to achieve a uniform distribution of radiation in the adjacent tissues to avoid the hot spot. The radiation should be distributed uniformly to avoid hot spots, which can cause excessive damage to the normal tissues. If there is more radiation in one area, that damage the excessive damage to the normal tissues, that is known as hot spot. And sometimes there may be cold spots, which can lead to under treatment of the tumor. If there is less radiation dose, less dose distributed one area, then it causes under treatment, and that is the cold spot. So the radiation should be distributed uniformly. So this is the isodose curves of a standard radium insertion using the Manchester technique for carcinoma of the cervix uteri. Carcinoma cervix. The dose at point A is taken as 100%. So you know, in cancer cervix there are 2 points: point A and point B. And the point A is the 2 centimeter above and 2 centimeter lateral to the external os, and point B is 3 centimeter lateral to the point A. So if the intrauterine tendon is placed inside the uterine cavity, then the point A gets 100 radiation dose of 100%, and gradually, according to the inverse square law, the radiation dose is decreased and laterally. So gradually it is decreased to 75 and 50 in dose B, and laterally 30%. So gradually the dose is decreased according to the inverse square law. So it is beneficial because the normal tissues are less damaged as the dose is decreased gradually, laterally, where the normal tissues are present. Away from the tumor tissue, the normal tissues are present. So there is less damage of the normal tissue due to less dose of the radiation, according to the inverse square law. In brachytherapy for cancer of cervix, the limiting factor is kept in mind. The point A and point B we have discussed, and it is the point A is the anatomical location of the crossing of the uterine artery and ureter. So a dose exceeding 8,000 rads should not reach this point. Otherwise, there will be damage to the ureter. And the point B, to irradiate maximally, point B located 5 cm from the uterine axis or 3 cm from the point A laterally, and the dose should be 5000 rads. And this point represents the lateral pelvic wall or presence of the obturator node, and the radiation dose achieved at the lateral pelvic wall would be low due to the inverse square law, as low as 1000 rads. The bladder and rectal mucosa cannot withstand over irradiation. That is why gauze bag should be given to safeguard the bladder and rectum, and in rectum withstands 5000 rads and bladder 6000 rads. So adequate packing of the vagina should be done, and so that the bladder and rectum is displaced, and the bladder and the rectum should be also empty. And optimal safe dose depends upon the radiation tolerance of the normal surrounding structures, bladder, rectum, intestines, liver, and kidneys. Thank you. So another, in brachytherapy, there are also low dose rate and high dose rate is also given. So this all about the up to brachytherapy. In the next class, we'll discuss other parts of the radiotherapy. Any doubt you have? So thank you all very much. Stay safe and healthy. Any doubt you have? Any doubt, or you can chat. You can have any doubt if you have any doubt. Okay, thank you.